here's a COVID-19 news update from Delhi on April 14th. The biggest story in the national capital is, of course, the numbers. The number of COVID-19 cases in Delhi jumped to 1,510 after 356 new cases were confirmed on Monday. This is the highest spike in a single day in Delhi. Over 90% of the new infections that got confirmed on Monday are found to be linked to the congregation that took place at the Tablighi Jamaat headquarters in Nizamuddin Basti last month. The death toll has also risen. On Monday, Delhi reported 4 more deaths, taking the COVID-19 death toll in the city to 28. Last evening, the government also declared 4 new containment zones in the city for COVID-19. So now Delhi has 47 containment zones in all. Today in the metro section of Hindustan Times, we have tried to explain what parameters are used in deciding what a containment zone would be. Just for better understanding, containment zoning involves more than the usual lockdown. It has stricter restrictions. These zones could be a block, it could be a building, it could be a gated community, or even a neighborhood. People living here are not allowed to step out of their homes, and essentials are home delivered directly to them by the authorities. So, how does the administration mark out these containment zones? According to an order by the Delhi government's Directorate General of Health Services, which our story quotes, the higher authorities must undertake containment activity even if there is a clustering of 3 cases. But the order also says that the final demarcation of containment and buffer zones has to be determined on the ground by the district authorities as per the geographical boundaries of the area of the cluster. There are multiple factors such as population density, proximity to higher risk areas, the inability to track the source of infection, that are also considered while deciding what a containment zone would be. Our report cites examples. Containment zones such as Chandni Mahal, Nabi Kareem and Sadar Bazaar, for instance, were sealed after clusters of COVID-19 cases were reported from these areas. Parts of Nizamuddin West neighborhood were declared containment zone because of their proximity to the Tablighi Jamaat headquarters in Nizamuddin Basti. Vardhman apartment in Mayur Vihar was declared a containment zone, although there was just one case reported from this area. But authorities have told us that it became difficult to protect the common areas and utilities of the society from contamination, and that is the reason why they declared this housing society as a containment zone. So these zones have to follow an enhanced safety protocol, which Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal has described as Operation Shield. So what is Operation Shield? The S in Operation Shield stands for sealing, H is for home quarantine, I is for isolation and tracing, E is for essential supplies, L is for local sanitization, and D is for door-to-door checking. But maintaining protocols is a big task and it requires all hands on deck. Another report in the metro section has pointed out how the district administration, which has to implement this protocol, is facing a staff shortage. So the Delhi government has decided to help out, and 13,000 booth level officials have been deployed for surveillance and disinfection drives, and the government is also asking medical students to join various containment activities. So 110 students from Maulana Azad Medical College have been engaged in the 11 districts in the city, and similar arrangement is being made to bring students from the University College of Medical Sciences on board. There are already 5,900 ASHA workers and 1,270 auxiliary nurses, midwives who are deployed across districts for collecting data and conducting health checks. Another 7,700 civil defense volunteers have been engaged to provide food, doorstep delivery of essentials. They're helping out the police in enforcing the lockdown. They're helping in contact tracing and surveillance. But there is still a staff crunch, and the Lieutenant Governor of Delhi has now asked the health department to create a pool of retired medical professionals who can help out. The Chief Secretary of Delhi has also asked all district magistrates to constitute a Corona Foot Warriors containment and surveillance team in their districts. So this is what we have on the containment zones in Delhi. There'll be more updates from us tomorrow. So till then, stay safe and stay at home.